Welcome learners in our today's lesson, and today we're going to look at Introduction to Management Information System. So this unit is meant to give you knowledge as learners, give you skills so that you can be able to understand and be able to describe the importance and various applications of management information systems in what you call organizations. So basically these are just systems that are meant to give managers information, meant to provide information which is accurate for management purpose. So we shall start by defining some terms. So the first term is data. So data basically are raw facts which are meaningless to the owner, e.g. let's say the admission number of a student, the name of a student is what you call data. Then you have what you call information. So information is what you call data that has been put in a form that is meaningful to the recipient and is able to add value to the current situation, or what you call prospective, or what you call make an individual to come up with an action or make what you call a judgment. So we normally base on information to make judgment, and information is basically power, because once we are given information, it means we are empowered to make certain decisions. So how can we come up with information? We have information systems that basically their main aim is to acquire data from the raw environment, in terms of from customers, in terms of suppliers, and try to make that data meaningful by performing certain activities such as processing in terms of adding, multiplying, comparing, sorting, summarizing, so that at the end of it, it has what you call information. And we are saying basically information is what you call data that has been organized in a presentable manner and allow someone to make decisions. Now, once we acquire this data in form of information, in form of, let's say, we hear or we see and we understand, we are able to understand this information, we call it knowledge. So knowledge is information you hear, you see, and you are able to understand it. Now, once we distill this knowledge and be able to integrate in our understanding and apply it to make certain judgment, to solve certain problems, it means we call it what we call wisdom. It's known as wisdom. Then another term is information, not management, sorry, management. And management basically is act, or what you call activity, or what you call controlling, monitoring, looking at activities, how they are performed. If it's about employees, looking at how employees are performing the activities. If it's about your siblings, looking at how they are well in terms of their well-being. So basically you are saying management is the activity of getting things to be done through a given particular formal way, which is more organized. And the basic function performed by management, basically a manager, is one is organizing. You have to come up with plans on how activities are going to be performed in terms of staffing, coming up with enough manpower and assigning them tasks or duties, and basically directing, coming up with directions in terms of activities which are going to be performed by each and every individual. Another terminology is system. So basically a system, like a human being is a system, a computer is a system. So a system is a set of elements which are interrelated, which are independent, and they must work together to achieve a common objective. So a system is a set of independent components which must work together so as to achieve a common objectives. The elements are independent. They doesn't depend on others. Each element can work on its own, but they must work together so that the system can achieve its objectives. Now, another term is what you call Management Information System, MIS, Management Information System. Basically, these are class of system that has devices, that has people, that has programs, and the main aim is to serve a firm with information. So basically, it's a class of systems that provide an organization with information that it relies on so that it can make decisions. So an MIS system will gather data from multiple sources. It can also acquire data from another system. It can acquire data from directly from customers, from suppliers, come and analyze make it more presentable, more organized, what you call information, and display in form of reports. Then if it is displayed in a report, it means a manager can base on that report to make judgments. For example, we can come up with total population of KIPPS College in terms of students taking different courses. If you are taking, let's say, accountancy, there are 10. Those who are taking ICT, there are 20. Those who are taking hospitality, there are 30. Then we add, we come up with total population. Basing on this total population of KIPPS, a manager at KIPPS College can make a certain decision in terms of basically the performance or what you call the total population. You see that this particular course has 20 students this year. Last year it had 5 students. It means there's some growth in this particular course. If last year had 5 students, now this year this course has 1 student. It means there's a decline in the growth of the number of students doing that particular course. So we can make a decision either to change that course, either to improve on it, or either we do away with that given course. So we are saying once managers are given information, they are able to make certain judgments, certain decisions. Then you can move to the features of information, which are same as characteristics of information. So one is accurate. The information must be free from errors, because if it has mistakes, it will guide us to make wrong judgment or wrong decisions. Number two, the information must be complete. It must include all the needed details, all the relevant details, so that it can allow us to make informed decisions. It must be cost effective. Cost effective means the amount of money we incur in coming up with this information, as you compare that with the benefit of that information, always must be lower. So we cannot incur so much in acquiring information. So the amount incurred must be at least average. Then number two is what you call accuracy was number one. Number two is complete. Number three is cost. Then number three is what you, four is user focused. The information must be presented in such a way that it should address the information requirements of a target user. They say an operational manager can require certain detailed information, and this should be considered when presenting that information, that given operational manager. We cannot give him or her a different kind of information. The user, if a certain user X needs this particular information in form of a report, that user must get that given information. Another one is what you call relevant. The information must be relevant to the recipient. It must be direct related to the problem that that recipient wants to address, wants to solve, or that particular recipient is facing. If the ICT department wants to buy a new device to act as a server to store data in an organized manner, it means the information that talks about, let's say, a 40% discount, given a discount on laptops, will be not relevant. The information in this scenario, it means, must be looking at the features of a server, comparing different classes of server in terms of their features, in terms of their storage capacities, in terms of their cost. But if you give that particular manager and ICT department the information about discount being given to laptops, it means we are not enabling that particular manager to solve or address that given problem. Another feature is what you call timely. The information be available when it is needed. We cannot delay, because once we delay, we are going to incur losses. Now, we can move to another term, which is basically information systems. So we are saying information system is a combination of technology, a combination of tools, ideas, knowledge that enables a firm to acquire information. So when you talk of combination of technology, ideas, knowledge, it means we have the physical devices or hardware, we have what you call software, which is same as knowledge, and these devices must be, let's say, interconnected. So we need to have an element of what you call connecting them, and there's someone who will operate that element. So we have people, we have the physical devices, we have the element of interconnect known as network, then you have the knowledge that will get the physical devices on how to operate. All that is what you call the resources of information system. So basically is a system that provides a given firm with information. For this system to come up with information, it means it has to acquire data from the external environment through SA customers, through suppliers. It has to be able to manipulate, convert that data into meaningful information. It must have the ability to store, keep that information for some time. Then it must have the ability to display or disseminate the information. So the system is made up with components, and these components must work together. In acquiring data, there's a component that it will use. In converting data into information, you have a component that will perform that activity. In keeping information, in displaying information, the components that will perform those activities. So these components must work together because it is a system. And the main aim of this system is basically to come up with information which is needed in day-to-day activities, in making a given firm to attain a competitive advantage or stay ahead of the competitor and meeting their objectives. So basically those are terms. Then from there you can move and look at what you call objectives of MIS. Objectives of MIS. One objective of MIS is basically data capturing. Most of the management information systems will capture data. And once they capture data, they must convert this data into information. So this can be done through activities such as calculating, sorting, classifying, summarizing, etc. Then from there, another objective is basically storing that information. We can come up with information about the patterns, buying patterns, behavior, preferences of customers. Then we stay with that information for like 1 year before we can now look at that information and analyze and based on it to make certain decisions. So the MIS must have the ability to store information either for future reference. Then you have the ability to retrieve as another objective, retrieving information. It must give information when it is needed. So the activity of accessing information is what you call outputting to various users. That's what you call disseminating also. And the system must always provide information to assist in making decisions. So when we have a firm that doesn't have management information system, it means there's poor decision-making activities. But the ones that firm acquires management information systems, it will facilitate smooth sharing of information. The firm will have informed decisions, so they are going to improve on the element of making decisions. So basically the purpose of management information systems is basically to improve our decision making. How? By providing up-to-date, accurate information in basing on what you call the financial status of a firm, basing on inventory, things we need in that firm, basing on the personnel in terms of the pay you are paying them, basing on marketing strategies you are coming up with, so that the firm can work at a more efficient way and the firm can grow and achieve its objective. So the MIS collects data, it will store that data, it will come up with what you call information and give that information to managers. And managers, mainly they want to use that information to analyze the data and make certain decisions. So basically, we are saying is an important tool, is an important a way of enabling firms to achieve their objectives and enabling firms also to stay ahead of the competitor. Staying ahead of the competitor means doing things differently in a unique way. Now, we can also proceed and look at what we call components of MIS in our next video, and this will be looking at the lesson number 2, the second lesson, which will basically focus on the components, what make up an MIS system. Thank you.